Hello student, welcome to Ashtech channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. In this video, today we will going to study BCD addition and conversion. So in BCD addition, after adding packed BCD number, the result is no longer BCD. You can see here. So you can see in this example, you can see when you add 17 and 28, you will get hexadecimal value 3F, which is not BCD. To get the BCD, what I have to do? So I have to do certain correction. So the programmer must add 6 to the lowest digit if it is crosses 9. Similarly, the programmer must add 6 to the highest digit if it is crosses 9. That is called as BCD correction. And that correction is done by using one instruction DA, decimal adjust for addition. Or decimal adjust for addition will do. It will add 6 to the lower nibble or higher nibble if it is required. Here you can see we have taken two data, 47 and 25, and I am moving data 1 to AL, data 2 to BL. I will add it, and we know definitely here when you add 75, the you will get the answer something like B. So in order to avoid this one, DA is required, because I want the result in BCD. DA is required. DA will do the correction and the result is stored in AL, and that is moved to data 3. So that is the job of DA, decimal adjust after addition, decimal adjust for addition. So now here you can see one example. So you can see the example here. So here we are taking one value 22 and 18. What is the value of 8 and 2? 8 and 2 is actually 10. You should get here value 40. But you will get the value here 3A, which is incorrect. So to make the correction, you have to add 6 here. 3A 6 here, you will get 40. That is done by DA instruction. Please remember, DA is nothing but decimal addition for, decimal adjust for addition. It will add 6 to either lower nibble or higher nibble during the addition. So we will continuing our session. We will see one program. This is from your textbook. The first one is two sets of ASCII data have come from the keyboard. Write and run program to convert ASCII to packed BCD, then add multi-byte packed BCD and save it, and convert the packed BCD result to ASCII. That means, so two sets of data have come. See, let me use your pen. Two set of data have come. That is, the one set of data is this one, second set of data is this one. So first you have to convert this into, this is ASCII, packed BCD. So this you have to convert packed BCD and you have to store here. And this one you have to convert packed BCD and you have to store here. After this, this both packed BCD you have to add it. This both packed BCD you have to add it and you have to store here. This is a result of addition of packed BCD. This is the result of addition of the packed BCD. After that, you have to convert into ASCII once again. So here I request all the student, this program is very big. So whatever program we taught you, that only you can write. For example, you should not think like the number is big and all, but you try to simplify the program. First, what is our task? Convert ASCII to packed BCD. So for ASCII to packed BCD, the program remains same. Whatever program I taught you in the previous video, same program you can write. So you can take two numbers. In the program which I taught you, we have taken small numbers. Here the number is somewhat very big. So you can take two numbers and you can write the program to convert ASCII to packed BCD. Then converting packed BCD to ASCII, that is also, once again, we have seen. Then the second one is adding two packed BCD. So that program we will see here in this session. So adding two packed BCD, let me explain you. You can see here, this is the procedure to add two packed BCD. One packed BCD is stored in data 3 location, other packed BCD is stored in data 4 location. I will move the offset address of that one to BX and offset address of that other one is to DI. After adding, I will store that the added result in data 5 underscore add and whose offset address is SI. I will take 05 as the counter. 05 as the counter because at a time in packed BCD we will take two numbers, there are total 10 numbers are there. Now first I will move al, bx plus 4. So let me take the number and explain you how this becomes bx plus 4. So let me write here the number. Let me write the number, BCD number, I will take the general number. Let me take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 0. This number, this is the number. Let me take. So here you can see, we have 5 iterations. If you take 2 numbers digits at a time, you have 5 iterations. That's why the counter I have taken here 5. Now move AL BX plus 4. When you add any two numbers, we start from right hand side. So first I have to take this number for addition, this number and this number I have to add. Here I have not written the number. Please assume there is a number I have to add. So now my BX is pointing to starting address of the data 3. Suppose if I take this is data 3, if I take this itself data 3, starting address here, I will take starting address is 0, then this is 1, this is 2, this is 3 and this is 4. And I have to start the addition from here. That's why I will write BX plus 4. I will move this number to AL and I will add this with the carry ADC AL with the DI plus 4, one more number. Then I will apply decimal adjust for addition. Then I will store the result in SI plus 4. After that, I will decrement BX. Now BX is equal to BX plus 4. BX plus 4, I will decrement it. Then the pointer will come here. And I will decrement DI similarly here. And for storing also, I will decrement SI. And this will loop 5 times. This is the simple addition. In the exam, they may ask, write a program to add two multi-word BCD numbers. Then that time, you can write this program. Only thing is, you have to make sure you use data segment, code segment, and initialization, all these. Here it is given main instructions only. They have given part of the program, not complete program. This is a procedure here. The complete program is there along with main and all, but in the exam you cannot write this much of big program. So you simplify it.